Amen.
Number one, know who you are. You need to know who you are. Amen. You cannot grow without knowing who you are.
Amen.
So know who you are. Number two, know whose you are. The sense of belonging gives the impetus to direction. Know whose you are. Know who you are. Know whose you are. Know where you belong. Many people and many churches don't grow. They don't grow because the people don't know who they are. They don't know whose they are.
Amen.
So church becomes like a chore because they don't know. When you know who you are, you know whose you are, you develop vision. Vision that resonates with the desire of God for your life. When you know who you are, you know whose you are, you develop vision. Vision that resonates with what God wills for you.
Amen.
When you know who you are, you are stable.
Amen.
When you know whose you are, you are stable.
Amen.
And you develop vision.
Amen.
That resonates with what God wills for you.
Amen.
I said, when you know who you are and you know whose you are, you develop vision that resonates with what God's desire for you is.
Amen. Amen.
When we do not know who we are, we cannot develop vision.
Amen.
When we do not know who we are and whose we are, we cannot develop vision.
Amen.
We have no inspiration, we have no desire to see us where we are going. When we know who we are and whose we are, we know that there is a place spiritually where we don't belong.
Mm-hmm.
When Joseph was in the pit, Joseph says, I don't belong here.
Amen.
I belong to the palace.
Amen.
Why? Because Joseph knew who he was.
Amen.
And whose he was.
Amen.
When Joseph was tempted to commit sin with Potiphar's wife, because Joseph knew who he was and whose he was,
Amen.
He fled from the place of sin.
Amen.
Because he knew he was a man of vision.
Amen.
If the church has to grow, if your church has to go somewhere, the people must know who they are.
Amen.
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 Teach your people to know who they are.
Amen.
Number two, whose are they? When they know who they are and whose are they belong, they develop a sense of vision.
Amen.
That resonates with what God wants.
Amen.
For every journey a man takes, it starts with one step of faith.
Amen.
But there is a difference between a man who knows himself and whose he is, and a man who doesn't know who they are and whose they are.
Amen.
The two men can start the same journey, but they will not end the same place.
Amen.
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 The question is, do you know who you are and whose are you?
Amen.
Under whose authority are you? Under whose leadership are you? Do you belong? Because without belonging, I cannot build.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Without belonging, I cannot build.
Amen.
Nobody can build a house that is not his own.
Amen.
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 When I know who I am, whose I am,
yes,
I develop a sense of vision that resonates with God.
Amen.
Remember the story of Jesus. While his mother and father, physical father Joseph, were hungry
going on to attend to their personal business, Jesus was left behind. Jesus went into his father's house. When they looked for him after 3 days, they said, "Why have you treated us thus?" And Jesus says, "Did you not know who I am? Amen. Don't you know whose I am? Amen. I am about my father's business."
Amen.
When you belong, you become a builder.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor and say, when you belong,
when you belong,
you become a builder.
You
quickly catch
the vision
of the church.
Amen.
Amen.
When you truly belong, belonging is a sense of knowing who you are.
Amen.
Right from the beginning of his life, Jesus knew who he was and whose he was.
Amen.
And as a result, let's go to the book of Second Luke, or Luke chapter 2. Jesus knew who he was. That is the struggle.
Yes.
I was asking God, what shall I say to you?
Amen.
And God tell me, go and tell them. They must know who they are. Number two, they must know where they belong.
Amen.
When they know who they are, then they can develop a sense of vision.
Amen.
That resonates with God.
Amen.
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 When we go to the book of Luke chapter 2, we want to read that story. Luke chapter 2. Luke chapter 2. Verse 41. Every year, his parents went to Jerusalem for the feast of Passover. When he was 12 years old, they went up to the feast according to the custom. Do you know that when a church does not have vision, it can develop a tradition?
That's right.
A tradition of people coming together.
A
tradition of you meeting.
Yes.
But when you are meeting, there's no vision.
Amen.
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 Mary and Joseph went to the feast year after year. They went because it was their tradition.
That's right.
We can come to church because it's our tradition.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
After the feast was over, verse 43, his parents were returning home. The boy Jesus, say the boy Jesus.
The boy Jesus.
It's not about age. It's about vision. Say the boy Jesus.
The boy Jesus.
It's not about age.
It's not about age.
It's about vision.
It's about vision. Amen.
Amen.
Although Jesus was young, Jesus had a vision.
Yes. Amen.
He had a vision.
Amen.
At the age of 12, he knew who he was and whose he was.
Amen.
Amen.
And it is that vision that prompted him to act the way he did.
Amen.
When he went to Jerusalem.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you hearing the word?
Amen.
Are you hearing the word?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
After the feast, verse 23, was over, while the parents were returning home, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. But they were unaware of it. Do you know that you, as a member of the church, you can begin to do certain things that people are not aware of?
Amen.
Do you know that you can come by yourself to do evangelism and people are not aware of? When you know who you are and whose you are, you develop a sense of vision.
Amen.
That resonates with God.
Amen.
Amen.
You develop a sense of vision.
Amen.
That resonates with God. God is looking for men and women who know who they are and whose they are, so that he can inspire them to develop a vision.
Amen.
That resonates with them.
Amen.
With him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to be quick here because I don't have a lot of time. I want to be quick here. You took all the time. So I don't have a lot of time, so I will have to be quick here. Let's go. Verse 44. Thinking he was in their company, they traveled for a day. Then they began looking for him among the relatives and friends. When they did not find him, they went back to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple courts. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus was not found outside. Jesus was found in the temple courts.
Amen.
Why? Because he was a man who knew who he was and whose he was. He had developed a vision that resonated with God.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you want to grow?
Amen.
Do you want next week to have people come here?
Amen.
Know who you are.
Amen.
Amen.
Know who you are.
Amen.
And know who you are. And know whose you are. God will develop a vision within you that resonates with him.
Amen.
That is our cry this morning.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are going. We want to quickly finish off.
That's right.
After 3 days, they found him in the temple courts, sitting among the teachers, listening to them, and asking them questions. Everyone who heard him was amazed. Everyone who heard him was amazed. When you know who you are and whose you are, and you have developed a sense of vision that resonates with God,
Amen.
You know what will happen? When people look at you, you become a wonder.
Amen.
When you look at you, you become a wonder.
Amen.
Everybody was in awe when they heard the testimony of Jesus,
Amen.
When they heard the passion of Jesus,
Amen.
When they heard the vision of Jesus,
Amen.
When they heard him talk,
Amen.
Everybody was in awe.
Amen.
Mrs. Saga can be in awe when they hear Kitchener talk.
Amen.
Cambridge can be in awe
Amen.
When they hear what Kitchener talk.
Amen.
Bradford may be in awe
Amen.
When they hear what Kitchener talk.
Amen.
But how does that begin? Know who you are and whose you are so that you can develop a vision that resonates with God.
Amen.
Amen.
That resonates with God.
Amen.
When one has a vision that resonates with God, one cannot wait for others.
Amen.
One cannot be prompted by man.
Amen.
One is now prompted by the vision
Amen.
That is deposited within us. The boy Jesus was left behind.
Amen.
The boy Jesus did not wander into unnecessary areas. The boy Jesus remained within the confines of the vision of God for him.
Amen.
Where was he found? He was found in the temple. His vision was stable from the early stages of his life.
Amen.
I challenge you, know who you are.
Amen.
And whose you are. You will develop a sense of what?
Vision.
That what? Resonates with what?
With God.
Amen.
And one who develops a vision that resonates with God is unstoppable.
Amen.
One who develops a sense of vision that resonates with Almighty God is unstoppable.
Amen.
Amen.
They are unstoppable.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I challenge you, wherever you are watching me, you are listening to me, and I'm here in Kitchener, I have come to prophesy
Amen.
That something will happen here in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I declare that you are about to discover who you are and whose you are,
Amen.
And you will develop a vision
Amen.
That resonates with God.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.